everything we perceive in our lives happens in perfect time. I'm going to tell you a little story, see if you've got your own story that relates to this one. I was working once with a young chap who, he actually told me, it was his story. When he was 17, he passed his driving test and he got his first car. A little old banger, it was about £300, and drove around. But he really wanted a much nicer car, so he worked for a year and saved a certain amount of money, and he decided whatever he saved he would match with a bank loan, and so move up a level. He did this, he organized it, he sorted out the money, and he went out and started searching for a car, and he came across a car that he thought was absolutely perfect. It was a gorgeous, black, shiny Renault 5. Newer than what he had, this was years ago, newer than what he had, nicer, it looked clean, it looked fine, and he arranged with the owner that he would come the next day and bring someone to take a look at the car and make sure it was clean and okay. And the next day he was about to go with his mechanic to have a look at the car. Do you remember the days when we used to take our mechanics to look at our cars and we wanted to buy them? And the guy phones him up and he says, "Sorry mate, it's sold." And this guy was so upset. He's devastated. "What do you mean it's sold? But it's mine." But it wasn't his. And he was absolutely sure that he had lost the car that was meant to be his. It was his in his mind. He owned it. That was it. It was his. And he was really upset for a few days. And one day as he was walking in the street, he saw this really gorgeous car drive past. It had a little sale sign on it. So he quickly wrote the number and phoned the person up straight away. And they arranged to meet further down the street. And this was a red Honda, which years and years and years ago kind of looked a little bit like a Porsche. Had a lot more buttons in it, had a lot more facilities. You know how, you know, the Japanese certainly had more features in their car even when it was the same age as the Renault. And he went to see this car and he was like, "Wow, wow, it's got a roof that opens with a button, it's got a fifth gear. This is amazing." So he took the person to the mechanic and they had it checked on the spot. He bought that car. And it was only after he had this one that he was so grateful that he never bought the black Renault 5. Because he got what he needed in perfect time. He did not control that outcome. How many of you have missed out on a job that you thought was perfect?